Okay, so we've seen a lot of really cool dragons in the series, but Eileen, her dragon form has to be my absolute favorite dragon we have seen all this entire time. It used to be Igneel. Igneel used to be the most badass dragon I've seen in the series, but Eileen, she just takes the fucking cake. I mean, just look at her character. She is so fucking badass looking. What's up, guys? Okay, so chapter 518 is out early again, out on the same website I gave you the link to last time. Although this time I recommend not reading it just yet. I recommend waiting until a different website uploads it, mostly because in this chapter the dialogue was really weird. Like, things that Eileen and Erza were saying just didn't really fit, and I think it might have just been a translation error, so I recommend waiting till someone else translates it and uploads it to a different website before you go and read it, because you'll just be confused while you're reading it and have to read it multiple times before you understand what the fuck's going on and just realize that, oh, this is probably out of place or this was probably mistranslated. But anyway, yeah, I definitely recommend you waiting until like Monday or whenever any other website uploads it to read the translation. All right, so let's just jump right to the chapter where I was a little disappointed at first. When the chapter started out, I was a little disappointed because it just didn't have any Natsu in it. I wanted to see what's going on with Natsu. I wanted to see what's going on with him and his whole subconscious, learning more about his past, learning more about what's going on with that demon and dragon seed fusing together. I was hoping to see some of that this chapter, but we didn't get any of it. And after I read it through a second time again because of the translation, I had to read it again in order to understand what's going on until I realized that, translation was just kind of messed up. I realized that there was no part of this chapter that you could just take a break from the fight and just go over to look at what's going on with Natsu in his dream state. It just wouldn't fit because the fight had officially started now. I mean, before you could have done it because the fight hadn't really started. They were still kind of just going through the motions, just, basically going through the dialogue, explaining what's going on with Irene and Erza's past. But in this chapter, they're officially fighting, they're officially going at each other, so you had to devote this chapter all fully to a fight. Because any other way, it would just felt weird and, out of place. But, yeah, I was a little disappointed, like I said, but at the same time, now that I reread it again a few times, I understand what Mashima was trying to do. There was no place for Natsu in this chapter. We'll probably see him in about two other chapters from now. Like, two chapters from now, we'll probably get back to that storyline because I don't think next chapter we'll be able to see him either. Maybe not, at least till the end of that chapter. But anyway, let's just get right into what happened in this chapter. We see Eileen and Erza going at it. Like, the fight has officially started, finally. And the two of them, for the most part, are pretty evenly matched. They're both doing everything they can to attack each other, and neither one of them are really landing any hits. And at the same time, they're bantering back and forth. Eileen is just like, "You're not my daughter. I hated you ever since you were born. I hated you. I threw you away, left you in that village to die. And do you really think you could take on someone who's been alive for 400 years, who's the queen of dragons?" And Erza basically comes back here and says, "I sympathize with you. I don't hate you for what you did to me. I sympathize with every tragedy that you went through. But I also went through a tragic life." She goes over the whole village thing, how her village got taken over and how she was basically a slave for a few years. And she said, "But because I had friends watching out for me and because I had my guild, I was able to turn that into strength. All that misery that I had into strength and get past it." And this is where I think the translation kind of dipped off or got messed up. Because there was no real point to this whole argument. I feel like in a proper translation, Erza's point would be, "Because I had people with me, because I had a family and friends, I was able to turn that misery into, fuel to get stronger so I can protect them, because I had something to work towards. But since you were alone for so long, for 400 years basically, you had no one to turn to, no one to protect, so you just turned that misery into pain and went insane for this. And I feel sorry for you for that, but because you're attacking my guild, because you're trying to kill my friends, I will defeat you." I think that's the message that Erza was trying to give out, but again, the translation just didn't deliver it. Anyway, the two of them are pretty much evenly matched, and Irene's like, "All right, you know what? I'm done. I'm done playing around." And she turns into her dragon form and is as beastly as ever. And she just swats Erza away, and she breaks every bone in Erza's body except for her right arm. Her right arm is the only thing that she can move, and it actually comes to that's actually a key factor in the chapter later on at near the end. So after Eileen breaks Erza's arm or breaks her entire body, she's just sitting there taunting Erza, just like, "Did you really think you could beat me? I'm a fucking dragon. You had no chance whatsoever. And in my dragon form, I'm even more powerful than I was before. So now I'm not just like the queen of enchantments. I'm like the god of enchantment magic." And she proves it by enchanting a fucking meteor from space and have it crash down on Earth, or have it coming towards Earth to crash down. Now, Erza realizes what's going on, because it's kind of the same as Jalil's magic, where you can kind of summon the meteor down, but on a fucking way master, like, it is way more massive than that. And Erza knows that there's no way she's surviving this. There's no way anyone will survive this if it hits. So she struggles her best to get her body to move, and it just won't move. It's nothing but her right arm. So she uses her equipment magic to equip a glove that gives her the strength to push her body up to face off against the meteor. And then she's basically saying that if I had to die, I will sacrifice myself to protect my guild by destroying this meteor. Because you may be the queen of dragons, but I'm the queen of fairies. And the translation was still a little off in this part, but it was the most badass speech I've ever heard Erza give. Now, here's the thing about Erza taking on this meteor. She has to die. Yeah, she has to die. There's no getting around it. This is something that she just can't take on. This meteor has to kill her. Because, yes, we have seen her be a badass throughout the entire manga series since she was introduced. But this is a meteor we're talking about. Her entire body is broken. She's been through countless fights, has been tortured, has been basically gotten the shit beaten out of her, should have died multiple times throughout this whole entire war arc already. Her body is just basically destroyed right now. She's basically running on fumes. If she survives this, then it's complete bullshit. Even Mashima has to know that it's bullshit. Unless the fact that she was born after Eileen turned into a dragon gives her that kind of power of being a dragon. Maybe not have her turn into a dragon herself, but have Eileen say that, oh, because you were born while I was a dragon, you are now a dragon too. You have the dragon body. You have, like, the power of a dragon. That's how you were able to beat the meteor. Because that's the only way you can excuse it. Otherwise, it's just kind of bullshit. Yeah, that's all that happened in the chapter, and that's all that's going to happen in the next chapter. She's going to beat the meteor. She's going to survive somehow, or maybe Mashima will finally kill her off. He already killed off Makarov, so it's not out of the realm of possibility that he will kill off another character. And this will be the perfect time to kill a character off, because you know he's not going to kill Natsu. You know the same thing's going to happen that happened to Ravemaster, where Natsu dies, and it comes back in the final chapter. So this will be the perfect opportunity to kill off a major character. But we'll see what happens in the next chapter. That's it for the review. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, drop me a like, subscribe to the channel. I'd greatly appreciate it. Comment down below with your thoughts on the chapter and what's going to happen in the future chapters. And I'll catch you guys later. Peace.